This week in Onuha Uncensored.
Went from, let's say, 5 to 7K days to 20K days on Facebook.
I have 1.2 million membership reward points.
Ferraris in the back.
This is what you can have available for yourself if needed. Hey guys, I'm here in the lab, in the office. So here we have my American Express dashboard. So as you can see, I have to pay like 231K. It's no problem, it's all or mostly because of ad spend. But what I want to show you guys is membership reward points. As you can see here, I have 1.2 million membership reward points. So what can you do with these points? You can transfer them in for free flights. So you can use these to fly business class for free, or you can use these to stay in a hotel for free. Honestly, I only use it for flights. So let me show you guys here. Transfer to partners. Then here you have all the different partners. So this card is my Amex Gold card here from the Netherlands. So from the Netherlands, you want to choose this one. So it's Flying Blue. Just if you have Amex Gold, just set up a Flying Blue account and you can transfer points. If you don't yet have an Amex Gold card, but you want to, and you are inside my elite program, you get access to my contact person. He will onboard you. And the beautiful thing with e-com and with spending money on ads online with your Amex Gold card is that with every euro you spend, you get one membership reward points. And here you can see 5 membership reward points is 4 miles. So yeah, let me do a transfer. I think I'm gonna transfer like 300,000 right now, something like that. I don't really need more because these are for KLM. So KLM is very good. It's the best flying partner from the Netherlands, but I'm gonna fly to Dubai, and you also have Emirates. But these reward points, you cannot directly transfer to Emirates because Amex Netherlands is partnered with Flying Blue. So anyway, what I'm gonna do here is put 300,000. Boom. And then I'm going to put my code here. As you can see, 300,000 will be 240,000 miles. And just for your information, a business class ticket with KLM at the moment is 75,000 miles. So yeah, with this, I can book a lot of business class tickets. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm flying out on Wednesday to Dubai. I think I'm just going to use KLM. I also have another Amex card. There we have it. Complete transaction. Bang. There we go. Still have a lot of them left, but it's all good. Yes, guys. So yesterday we managed to do 83K on the Eurostore. Very good conversion rate. So Thijs, how did the email of yesterday do?
Good, good, good. Performance was good. So yeah, the results need to come in. So it takes some time, but the text email from Friday did again 31K. So happy with the results, but the email from yesterday needs to go way across that.
So 83K on a Sunday.
Yeah, it's better. And we have the US and the UK store. We optimized it. So we also see that back in the email. So
happy with the results?
Yes, happy, but it can be better.
Can be better. That's always
can be better.
Hey, but Ruben, you come back totally crashed from Ibiza, mm-hmm. And then you see a little 83K day. What's that?
Yeah, shit's still running.
Yeah.
Of course. That's why we set up the business correctly. We have some great people working for us. So I'm happy that everything still runs smoothly, even when I'm not available for a few days. So
times have changed.
Of course.
Well, when I went on holiday, it all came crashing down.
Yeah, I still needed to do the customer service back then when you went on holiday with your friends back in the days.
Crazy. Yeah. So guys, 83K on a Sunday. So we cannot complain. Okay guys, as you can see right here, I'm in the KLM app. Yesterday, I did the transaction of 300 or 240,000 points. So here they landed already. Normally they say it takes like 10 days, but it is here in 24 hours. So that's good because I will book a flight for tomorrow. So if I go here to buy now, one way, Amsterdam, Dubai, business, use my miles. As you can see, starting from 75,000 miles and then the date. So tomorrow it's Wednesday, 30th. So as you can see, 75,000 miles is what it will cost, plus 151 euro for a business class flight. So that's great because normally you would pay like a couple K select. So yeah, now I'm gonna fill in my details and then the flight is booked. So boom, here you can see tomorrow you are heading to Dubai. So see you guys. Let's go to Schiphol, going to Dubai. Quick Dubai trip.
How long?
Week or so to fix some things, some bank accounts. Yeah, Ruben just got back, so now Ruben can be at the office. So we keep things running with Icon and everything. A bit hurry, in a hurry now.
They're waiting you, right?
Yeah. How do you feel, Ruben?
Yeah, shit, I need this man. One going out.
Why?
Jungle.
Yeah, from Ibiza, normally last time I came back, I felt good, but this time, I don't know what it is. I think headache all day. So, yeah, let's chill out for a bit, 1 or 2 days, and hopefully then I feel fit again.
Because normally it's 1 day recovery and then I'm fine, but this time it takes longer, so don't like it, but eat some good food.
The
price you have to pay.
You wanted to do another Ibiza. I was like, nah, I'm good.
Yeah.
Let's go get some money, fuck they playing. I told her take this plan, B, and stop playing. I'm tired of buying jewelry, finna buy some land. They still trying to figure out who I am. Who I be. Pillow talking.
Hey guys, I'm here at the KLM Crown Lounge. Obviously when you book a business class ticket, this is the lounge where you can go to. So let's get it, guys. I will share with you what you have here. If you like it, you can also, when you have as much Amex points as me, just transfer them in for a business class ticket. One thing personally I don't like about this business lounge is that often it's too busy. So right now, for example, it's pretty busy. Of course, you still have a lot of places to sit, but I don't know. I like more exclusive, but yeah, you have to do something with them Amex points, right?
I know consistency is key, but it's hard to stay consistent when you're in the mixer. Consistently a G, I'm still dishing out them keys, so I'm sorry if you're missing me on beats. Wanna know why I'm missing? Listen to me, please. I walk around town with enough jewels to change a nigga's life.
So yes, guys, I couldn't help myself. I booked the suite, but then had to upgrade to the even more crazy suite. So, presidential. We'll show you guys. So we are here on the 15th floor, which is the highest floor for the hotel side, 1503. So let's see. They only have 4 of these in the whole Address Hotel. And Address is, I think, hands down the best hotel in all of Dubai. Here we have it, 1503. Okay, let's see. Jeez. Wow. Jesus. Man. So here we have the desk. This is one of the reasons why I upgraded. Because look at this desk. I'm gonna get a monitor and then I'm gonna have some crazy grind sessions here. But man, this suite is sick. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey guys, I'm here in the suite. I'm hungry as fuck. It's like 1:30. AM. Let's see. They have a lot of good choices. Pizza? Nah, fuck pizza. Also healthy shit, but what I ordered, it's not 100% the healthiest, but I ordered Indian curry, butter chicken. Bro, if you don't know, you don't know. Butter chicken is good as fuck. For all my Indian brothers and sisters, I support you. I support you. Hi, sir. Come in. Yes, yes. How are you today?
Very good, and you?
Good, yeah. I'm hungry, but you bring good food. Yes, guys. So, midnight butter chicken. I know it's not good to eat before bed, but fuck it, nigga. I make money.
And the Skyview, private chair.
Went to pick up my bag from my room, and I come back, someone took my spot. Hey, you took my spot. So as you can see, yesterday 28,000 net profits, 81,000 in revenue. Yes guys, so this barbershop is inside Bloomingdale's. So you can also buy fashion, Dior, Palm Angels, There's like a hidden barbershop with my Nigerian brother who always delivers the best cuts. So that's what we're gonna get. Yeah, not too bad.
She couldn't stop. She couldn't stop. I pray to God that I see it all. He think he's shining my niggas on time when we take everything but his sneakers and socks. Mention my name when you speak of the block. Picture my face when you reach for the Glock. I could just do.
Thank you, brother. Yes, guys. Fresh trim here at Bloomingdale Chaps and Co. Gotta look fresh, right? Guys, you cannot walk around with a dead trim if yesterday you did 70k in a day. That's how it is, right? At the moment, we're doing good, you know, good numbers. Last Sunday did 80k, and now yesterday 70k with 25,000 profit or so. So I had to get a fresh trim, man. Can I have blueberry bujisen with almond milk? Yes, guys, here outside waiting on my Uber. Getting back to the hotel. I have a call with Jericho, one of my private clients who is crushing it. I have a call with him in about 20 minutes. Just came from the barber, obviously fresh trim. We're killing it, man. We are fucking crushing it, obviously. August is a shitty month. 1.4 million over all stores. That's like $1.6 million. Today, 27K. Yesterday, 70,000 bucks, guys. Here from Dubai, waiting on my Uber. I'm thinking about getting a new car here. Now looking at the G-Wagon. What will I get? G-Wagon is, of course, for G's, but I don't know if it's something for me. I already have on my mind what I'm gonna get. You guys tell me in the comments what you think I have on my mind.
First of all, thank you, of course, Samuel, for this given opportunity. That was a really great experience with you and the whole team, with Dennis and everyone from the community. Basically, what I did, I went from, let's say, 5 to 7K days on Pinterest to 20K days on Facebook, and I really elevated my whole dropshipping business. I went from the basics to a more advanced. I learned everything with regards to the backend, how to satisfy the payment processors, and also to provide the best quality of products to the customers. And within the last 3 months, everything really elevated for me, and everything, yeah, what I learned, I can of course implement in the strategy for Q4. I'm doing all the preparations now to go to the 500k months, and perhaps maybe the 1 million months, man.
Sick, man. Thank you, Jericho, and thank you for being a great client as well. And I expect only big things from you in the future. Yeah, guys, in the gym, making gains, making money, making deals. We're really doing this. We're really doing this, man. Look at this gym, all clean and that. How would you feel just training in gyms like this, checking your phone meanwhile, printing money, checking your emails, seeing deals come in, doing calls, making more plays, finding more partners, more connections, more everything. That's what happens when you put yourself in the right environment. Guys, you know you're in Dubai, you just train, put your 50K watches here, doesn't matter. People don't do shit here, just leave it. Nobody will do nothing. Guys, this life makes you feel good, but here you can see kind of the, can you see it properly? I wanted to show you the infrastructure. You can see the fucking infrastructure, man. Don't fuck with me, man. Don't fuck with me. Okay, guys, I'm gonna head out for dinner. Just gonna check where, because I'm busy as fuck. My alarm is going off left and right because I set alarms because I'm so fucking busy all day that otherwise I forget shit. I put alarms on to remind myself that I have to fucking work and execute, man. Guys, how the fuck is it possible that I'm out executing all of you? How the fuck is it possible? Ask yourself that question. How is Samuel out executing you? Samuel is doing, I showed you, 1.5, 1.6 million this month already. Already. How are you, like a lazy bitch on the couch, doing nothing, eating chips with your boys, smoking weed, going out for drinks this weekend, being a little soft bitch? How is that possible? And I'm out here winning at this level and still executing, still more disciplined than you. Ask yourself, how the fuck is that possible? Look between your fucking legs, and if there are some fucking balls, I hope that you are taking this serious enough that you know that you are the fucking one to change your life around and the one of your family. Don't be this complaining little bitch that is only like talking, oh,
Oh, it's everything is against me. The school system, the Matrix, they're all trying to get me. Bro, you are trying to fucking get yourself, man. What the fuck is this shit, man? I'm getting fucking angry. Why? Because I know how simple it is for you to change your life, but you are there fucking comfortable as fuck, man. It's annoying. It's very annoying. Why? Because I know if you just make a plan, get a good routine for yourself, invest in someone who is further than you, bro, can show you the road, show you the path, and like that, you are printing thousands a day. That's how simple it is. But you are there with your fucking limiting beliefs, doing nothing all day, only on your phone scrolling and hating on others in these fucking comments, in my comments, in everyone's comments. What is this shit, man? What is this shit? You can be here in fucking suites that cost 1K a fucking night. Do you understand this, man? Do you understand that this fucking suite here, where I'm here, fucking crushing it, it costs fucking 1K a night. And this is what kind of eco money can do. It's so simple. Why? You say, oh, that's 1K a night. Why? That's a waste of money, bruv. I made fucking 30,000 yesterday. 30,000. And now you, bitch. What the fuck did you make yesterday? 30 bucks? And you spend it on fucking OnlyFans? Nah, I'm tired of that shit, man. I'm very fucking tired of that shit. I hope you fucking see it in my eyes. I've sacrificed fucking everything to be here. To be able to transform thousands of lives. Made fucking people millionaire. I hope you fucking see this passion. I've done fucking everything for this shit, man. Fucking everything. What the fuck have you done? Ask yourself that question. Listen to what the fuck I just said. Means a lot. Okay, people, I think it's time to show you this fucking suite. I came here yesterday night. I was too fucking tired after my flight to record that shit. But here we fucking are. We're back in Dubai. We're in the address Skyview Hotel. Search that shit up. It's the best hotel in Dubai, or it's in the top 5 at least. But I'm gonna show you what 1K a night fucking gets you, like I just told you. This fucking suite, it's very fucking good. So I'm gonna show you the real route. So let me start at the fucking front door, nigga. Here you have the hallway. Yeah. This is 1503. They only make 4 of these. They have 4 of these in the whole address. So here, green, bang, inside. All right, this is how you enter. So you can go either to your front or you can go to your fucking left. You choose. I think we go left first. All right, here you have the living room, but let me show you the kitchen. I don't use the kitchen because who's gonna cook in Dubai if you have all the best foods of the world? I don't know what the fuck we even have here. Mini bar, always watch out with the mini bar. Always watch out, especially if you go to, but fuck it, you're making money, so spend that shit. Here we have some drinks. Let's see, do they have the more drinks? Not even, what's this for shit mini bar? Guys, let me tell you a fucking crazy story. Here you see a couple of bottles, right? Bro, I remember when I was last April, I was in fucking Dubai, 20th of April, celebrating my fucking birthday. So what did I do? Obviously, I'm Samuel Onua, so I rented out the craziest penthouse of 5 Palm. That motherfucker, it costed like 2K euros. 2K euros a fucking night. So we are in there, we had like a craziest party at Surf Club. Go check the reel on my Instagram if you want to see what the fuck we did. Bang, after party, you know how we do. Me and Ruben, obviously, we are with some birds at our place, doing our thing, having fun. From one thing happens another, I end up in my bedroom doing what I do best besides scaling my e-com store, scaling other things up. So, next morning, I wake the fuck up. It's like 9 a.m. in the morning. I open my phone. What do I see? I see a 5K Amex charge on my phone. 4 a.m. in the morning while I was sleeping. I was not even there. The fuck, 5K Amex charge by a 5 Palm hotel. So I was like, what the fuck was that? So I go on a little investigation. I had no idea what happened. No idea. 5K was charged on my Amex. So what did I find out? Here you see this mini bar, right? Well, in 5 Palm, they have a mini bar on a whole different level. These are small fucking bottles. There they have these motherfuckers. So what happened in the middle of the night, there were a couple of birds who were like, all right, everyone wants drinks? It belonged to the fucking penthouse. So what the fuck did they do? They opened all fucking bottles, each and every one of them. And they only took like 1 to 2 fucking sips out of it. I wake up next morning with a fucking 5K Amex charge from fucking 5 Palm. But that's what happens. That are things that happen when you make money.
No, you're not gonna get that money back. It's all part of it. You have a good story to tell. That's what the fuck you have. But here we have the living room. Nice couch, some chairs, obviously. Here when you enter, they put your name on that thing. I turn it off right now. Here's where the magic happens. The real magic, where I scale my shit up. I think I'm gonna get a big screen. I have a new one, like an iMac I got in Amsterdam, but I forgot to take it. I wanted to take it to Dubai. So yeah, here we have like the little working station is good. There you can charge your shit. Let me show you outside. We outside, bitch. Here, what the fuck do you have to say to this? What the fuck do you have to say to this? To this view. Here, obviously, we have the big Burj Khalifa. All the buildings. It's fucking crazy. Here we have the bedroom. Let me show you that motherfucker. But yeah, guys. Making money from this fucking thing can do a whole fucking lot. A whole lot. Wait, I'm gonna show you everything. So, what do we have here? Okay, see, this is where the fuck you enter. You're here, obviously. Nice bathroom, everything good. Let me show you some other magic happens. Big bed, all nice. Here we have the fucking vault. This is one of the most unused things in Dubai. Who the fuck needs a vault in Dubai? You can wear everything you want. You can wear a 50k watch, 200,000 watch, a 2 million watch. You can wear everything here. Here we obviously have the Sonua suitcase, walk-in closet, for who the fuck needs it. Here we have the beautiful fucking bathroom, bathtub. What do we have here? The shower, fucking toilet. What the fuck do we have here? Here we have the fucking man I fucking created myself, man. Man. Guys, you gotta be fucking proud of that guy in the mirror. Who the fuck are you becoming? Each fucking part of myself I built. Each fucking part. My money, my wealth, my health, how I look, every fucking thing I built. I did it myself. You can do the same thing, but who doesn't want to wake up each and every morning? You look in the fucking mirror and you see a fucking monster that you created yourself. Or do you look into the fucking mirror and you look fucking closely into your own eyes and you see a little bitch? Because deep down inside, you know that you chose the easy route. You know you chose comfort. Nah. I don't do that shit. I don't do that shit. If I know what the fuck I want, I go for that. Because I cannot sleep. I cannot sleep if I know I fucking want something, but I'm not going for it. I have way too much self-respect. Way too much, man. Way too much. And that's what the fuck you should have. I'm fucking happy I have that fucking pride. That fucking pride for my fucking father. Okay, guys. Quickly grabbed an outfit from my suitcase that I have not even put one single thing in my closet for. Yet because I'm fucking busy making money. So guys, here, yeah, little shirt, little Dior bag obviously, and some loose pants, Hermes fucking flip-flops. So I'm gonna eat something. I'm by myself, just me, myself, my thoughts, and my fucking Shopify on my phone. That's all I need. Guys, traveling by yourself is what built you. I went on my own to Dubai when I just turned 20 years old. I went on my own. I moved to Amsterdam when I was like 19. Guys, you have to make moves. All of you need a couple of... I don't know anybody, so I don't go. Fuck that shit, man. I've always done shit by myself. Obviously, now you see my little brother often with me, but still we do our own thing, still. Because we don't care, bro. If you want to level up, you have to put yourself in the uncomfortable situations. And if that means traveling alone, you fucking do that. Why? Because you want to fucking grow and elevate yourself. So, let's see what time it is. Oh, fuck no, I never put my time on my watches. This fucking broke boy does it if you have time on your phone. Wait, I forget my card. Yeah, fucking key. Okay, let's go. I have a call by 9 p.m. I've not eaten yet, so that's what I'm gonna do. Grab the elevator, down, bang. Also have like a c'est la vie at the 54th floor. Some fancy shit. But I'm gonna check now where I'm gonna eat because c'est la vie there. If you go there, you want to party, you know? And I'm in a different mode right now. Money making mode, nigga. Lobby restaurant. Let's go there. You have sky, you have c'est la vie, spa, pool there. It smells nice as fuck here. I don't know where the smell comes from. Hi, how are you? Thank you. Thank you so much. Can you maybe already bring some sparkling water? And also a Cola Zero, Coke Zero. Before I check the menu, let me walk around here for 1 second. I can show you some things. Here we have the pool. As you can see, look how crazy the building looks. Here we have the building, which everyone loves, right? The Burj Khalifa. So yeah, guys, gonna have some food right now. See you in a bit. Okay, guys, so we have the menu here of the Address Skyview restaurant. So what am I gonna order? I think I'm gonna go for the chicken Thai char siu, something like that, as an appetizer. Then as a main, obviously, if you're a real boss, you choose meat. because meat is testosterone, it's fucking power, nigga. So Wagyu strip loin 300 grams, that will do. Yeah, guys, I quickly switched tables because I don't know, it was windy as fuck there, and I'm not in Dubai to sit in like cold wind. So now I'm here, nice spot. Thank you so much.
Hey, you want a piece? You want a little piece? Hey, you also want? Yeah.
Always take care of your fucking cats. I take care of my pussy, like a real G. The waiter said, sorry for these cats. I said, no, I like it. I feed my cats fucking Wagyu. Hey, they fucking love it. You want more? Yeah, Wagyu. Yes, people, good fucking morning. 1st of September, 1st of a new month. Guys, this month is gonna be amazing. I am here behind my workstation. Rate this fucking workstation, guys. Here, the beautiful marble table. Got my phones making deals, transferring money to DHL for import. Here, you feel like a real fucking CEO. Yeah, guys. Just had a little coffee. Gonna go to the gym in a bit with my boy Vince. And afterwards, we're gonna eat breakfast. But yeah, man, feeling good. This life is fucking amazing. The way we are leveling up. Amazing morning, guys. Go after your shit. Make some money. Make yourself proud. Your parents proud. And that little voice inside you that wants you to level up. That's what I have. Of course, I have mornings. Also, this morning, I woke up. I didn't want to fucking go to work. I still go to fucking work. Why? Because I know all the things I have in my life, everything I've achieved, all the success, the lifestyle, the most beautiful things, they are here because I was able to push myself through the pain, through the discomfort and everything. If I would have listened to how I felt, bro, my life would not even be close to this. Bro, I would still be a fucking bitch. I don't listen to how I feel, and you should neither. You should listen to your commitments and where the fuck you want to go. All right, guys, have a beautiful day. Yes, people, let's go to the gym. Wearing my Whoop to clean that shit. I had a good sleep score last night, but my recovery is not good. Trying to improve my stats, but I don't know, man. I don't know, it's not improving. I think my body wants more sleep, but my mind wants more greatness. So what do you listen to? You listen to your body or you listen to your mind? I listen to my fucking commitments, nothing else. Let's make some gains, bruv. Look good, feel good, guys. Look good, feel good. What? Okay. Goed gevreden.
Ga je gym?
Ja, ik ga eerst even eten, kom op.
Dat is wel top hoor.
Ja, man, maar hey, die gang is kankerlang daar, op de andere kant.
Ja,
ja. Broer,
ik loop, je kan hem ook via buiten
pakken. Ik voelde me alsof ik door de catacomben ging.
Ja, bro, just zei net tegen mij van, bro, ben je die nooit verdwaald? Ik zei, nee, was één rechte lijn. Lijkt alsof je stadion in loopt.
Ja, man.
Bro, elke dag Champions League finale daar beneden. Ik draag zwaar aanvoerdersband daar, man. Speel ik tegen Klopp, ja.
Goed getraind?
Ja, man. Jaapie erbij.
Lekker, man. So now gonna get some breakfast with the boys. Have not eaten anything yet, so... Was making money, man, so... I will train after breakfast. It's all good. You like your eggs cooked or fertilized? Can I also order a scrambled egg with everything except cheese? Thank you. Some fruits. Watermelon. Love my fruits, nigga. Yeah, this is my secret to scaling my Shopify business. Two of these and scale to millions.
Don't forget the almond croissants, brother.
And the chocolate brownies.
For the fat fucks. If you need some tits, you eat this. Guys, if you want to stay lean, you don't see carbs, nigga. Who eats carbs? Carbs is for fat folks. So yeah, guys, gonna head out in a bit. I have like 6 more calls today. Preferably, I do max 4 calls a day, like actual Zoom calls. Of course, in the meantime, I have some calls on my phone, but doing too many calls will make your brain a fucking slush puppy. So I have 6 or 7 calls still left, all good. Still have to go to the gym, fucking busy. Everyone wants something from me, but the life I chose, right? I fucking love it. I love each part of it.
Hey Ruben, say something for the vlog.
19 November marathon.
You're gonna do a marathon? You will not finish it. No, you will never finish it.
I will finish it in 3.5 hours.
All right.
What do you say?
I say easy things, man.
I haven't trained before. I have never have run before, but I will make it work.
You only run from cops, right?
Yeah, I only run for grub.
You are African, right? You know how to run.
I only run for chicken and water.
Exactly.
And for hookers, if they ask too much money.
Yes. So Finn, did you find some good shit?
Bro, you know if you pass me the iPad, you know what's gonna happen.
Rough here. The whole thing, man. Like in Curaçao.
Don't remind me of that place, bro. What's up?
So we need some bread with chicken and pinda sauce.
Truki pan, vriend.
Die spicy pinda sauce.
Bro, bring the etiquette for me.
You're in the address. They know what the fuck they do, man. A man whips it up in the kitchen, man.
This is what up, boy.
Time for some good food. Only at breakfast today, so hungry as fuck, man. Hello, my friend.
Where do you stay in the room?
Very nice. I stay here outside in residence. Now my good friend here is here for a week. So I told him, of course, come to Skyview. It's the best place. Chicken
kit of your crib, sir.
Thanks so much for the service. Some good shit, man. Here with my hermano Vince. Only 5-star shit.
Delivered to the doorstep.
Yes. Yes, people. As we are growing rapidly with Icon, I decided to have a look for some additional funding. Why? Because Q4 is approaching, and obviously with the amount of inventory I ordered, it will be tight. It will be tight. Why? Because once the goods are ready, obviously you have to pay the manufacturer. We have good payment terms, but still the goods will go by boat and by container, and it takes 30 to 40 days before we receive the goods and also before we can start selling them. So this means that you have to put money in, meanwhile it's not instantly coming out. So I made the calculation. I was like, all right, if we can have some additional funding available, I don't know if I will use it, but if we have it available, would be great. So I reached out to a few partners here and there. Obviously you have these short-term financing partners which you can work with, and all of them, they really want to work with Icon, because they connect their software to our stores. When they look at our stores, they only see the numbers going up. So that's what I did, and right now I sealed the deal. Yesterday I signed the contract, and I will show you in the dashboard what the offer is that we received. So here you see the offer, 1.75 million euros from Uncapped. It's a line of credit, as you can see here. What that means is that this is not like the amount that you instantly will get or will need. This is what you can have available for yourself if needed. So let's say I need 300k tomorrow. I just send them an email and then they will send 300k. The fee is 5%. So let's say 300k, then the fee is 15k. That's how it works. It's very good, a line of credit, because that works kind of like on a need basis. So whenever you need it, you can have it. So I'm here in my suite, beautiful backdrop, obviously making good moves. It's very busy, but yeah, it is what it is. Q4 is approaching and I'm more than excited for what's to come. It's gonna be amazing next 4 months. So, and you guys will all be there on the journey with me. So subscribe to Onua Uncensored if you're not subscribed already. It's gonna be amazing, man. Like the episode, of course, because then the algorithm shows other e-com entrepreneurs that they need to check our shit. Need to check our shit, because we are the only one doing this shit, man. This motherfucker has six
Ferraris in the back. Brabus, Rolls. That's how we do it,
guys. There are levels.
McLaren, and this guy, this is one, because he has 6 parking spots in the same house.
This is why you live in Dubai. There are new levels. You cannot get comfortable with one dream car if you can have 6, guys. What is your neighbor doing? Probably wanking off or something.
Yeah. What the fuck is that? Bro, I don't even know what the fuck is under that curtain, but
it's probably a 1 of 10 Ferrari.
Yeah.
Let's put it in to top it off.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Little mansory in the corner.
Bro, it doesn't stop, man. It doesn't stop.
Bro,
if you don't have a Mansory, Cooley, Brabus, you don't even play games here. Fucking crazy, man.
They
just save them up.
Bro, literally every corner we take, new cars.
Oh, man. What the fuck is this? This is not normal, bro.
We need to work harder, bro.
Next time in Onuha Uncensored.
So going to Sun Beach.
This one day, catch today. They think who are these crazy guys here? Rolly on the wrist.
That's a little difference, right? First it was 11 point something. Now it's 7.5.